Hi, everybody. Welcome to Demo, the show where companies come in and show us their new products or features. Today, I'm joined by Rob McAveney. He is from Aras, and you are the CTO. And you're going to show us the Aras Innovator, right?
I am.
Okay, so tell me about what Aras Innovator is. As far as I know, it's a cloud-based product lifecycle management tool, but if you can expand on what that means.
Sure. So for context, Aras customers build planes, trains, and automobiles, as well as things like implantable medical devices or industrial robotics or even energy drinks. There's complexity involved in doing that. And many of our customers are using this this product to build their digital thread, which is what we're going to talk about today.
Okay, and for the most part, the main users of this would be who within a company?
Really anyone involved with the product. So anyone from engineering, procurement, quality control, service, anybody that's working with the product data would be a user of the system.
Okay, and you mentioned digital thread. So yep. What does that necessarily mean in terms of your scope?
Sure. So the digital thread is really bringing the data, the people, and the process all together to have interconnectedness, to have traceability across the product lifecycle. So if you imagine if you have a problem that's or an issue that's being reported, how do you trace that back, figure out its root cause, figure out whether the product is performing up to its original requirements? That's really what it's about, is that traceability across the product lifecycle.
And the problem that people would have before if they weren't using this product was, can I take a guess?
Please.
It's that they're all in little individual silos and they don't see this, you know, something at the end of the life cycle versus something in the beginning, and maybe they're just focused on this one area here.
Exactly, yeah. Exactly. So you have somebody that's in maintenance, for example, and they don't have any access to the original design. They have no idea why this problem is occurring, and they have trouble getting through organizational boundaries to actually collaborate with the designers and the people that manufacture the product.
That's why I like that term digital thread, because it's very visual. You can imagine a thread going through the entire stream here, right?
Exactly.
All right, so let's show the demo talk about a little bit about what we're going to be seeing.
So, I mean, just high level, the digital thread spans the entire product lifecycle. So everything from original design and original concept and requirements all the way through the operation of the product. And what Aras provides is a platform for product lifecycle management, as well as digital thread solutions that bring together a product data platform, low-code development environment to be able to adapt to different use cases. We have an application library that covers a lot of the different departments and organizations that we utilize it along the digital thread. And then we believe in a heterogeneous world in IT where you can't buy all your technology from one vendor. So you have to be able to do integrations with other systems that are involved in this product lifecycle.
That's an excellent point, yeah. So, okay, so what else are we gonna see here?
I think we're jumping straight to software.
Okay.
All right, so here's Aras Innovator.
Just real quick, what use case are we kind of talking about? Kind of set us up with a scenario.
Sure. So we're going to begin with a collaboration session where someone's a request has come in to research a problem. We're going to go through how all that research happens, how we're navigating the digital thread to get to the answer.
Yep.
So here we're looking at Aras Innovator. This is the initial screen, the dashboard. At the top left, this is really the process part of the digital thread, where I've been assigned tasks through workflows to do things like approve documents or sign off on engineering changes. The top right is the data side, where we have data residing or being created by all these applications at different stages of the product's lifecycle by different people. And all this data is coming together in that data integration layer to be able to handle it all together. And at the bottom of the screen, we're seeing what we call My Discussions, which is really like your social feed. Mm-hmm. So this is the people part of the digital thread, bringing them together to be able to collaborate about this data without having to in advance know who the design engineer that worked on this particular item might be. Now, it's important to note that all this is happening in context. So when someone asks me to please investigate, I can see what they're asking me to investigate and follow the link. And now I see the details of my bill of materials of my extruder assembly. So here we're working with a 3D printer, and this is the extruder sub-assembly for that 3D printer, and we're collaborating about this thing.
Okay.
And on the right side, we see the discussion that is now filtered only to this thing. So now anybody who comes in and needs to work with the extruder is able to visualize this. We can get into the details of what this user, Manish, was seeing when they created the report. So we're able to have markup and view for everybody in the organization. If we look at what's called the where used view, we now see all the connections from this thing to other things in the digital thread.
Okay.
So we can jump directly to, for example, the parent assembly. So let me open that thing up, and now we're seeing the full 3D printer as opposed to only the extruder.
Oh, okay, right.
And we can jump into a 3D visualization of this thing to be able to spin it and do all sorts of operations to be able to see more detail about what we're looking at. Let me just go ahead and zoom in on this thing and isolate it.
Okay.
And now we're looking directly at the extruder assembly itself. And of course we can rotate this. Let me go ahead and
those parts at the bottom were what were circled, right?
Exactly. Yep. Those nozzles at the bottom were circled.
I call them parts.
So now we can explode it and see how this stuff all comes together and kind of get a good look at the nozzles themselves. And here I can follow again a link. So this is a link between the 3D geometry. Now back to the data, we're looking at the details of this nozzle itself. And we can see that this was imported from a third party solution for 3D mechanical design, in this case, SolidWorks. And this is all coming in through that connectivity that we talked about at the beginning.
Right.
Other things that are connected. So as part of our research, we might look at the manufacturing process plan. So now we're jumping applications into the Aras manufacturing process planning application. And we can see all the work instructions for how this thing is assembled. Maybe that's part of the problem. Maybe the nozzle's getting clogged because we're assembling it wrong. Entirely possible. On the left side, we see a breakdown of all the operations and steps and tools and resources and consumed parts that you need. And on the right side, we're seeing the work instructions, the detailed instructions for how the technician on the shop floor actually puts this thing together. If we jump back to our where use view, we see some other things that might be of interest. So here is, in this case, a simulation study. So when we're designing this 3D printer, we do lots of simulation to predict how it might perform in different conditions.
Okay.
Right, and one of the ways we do that is by creating this simulation study that has a bunch of steps that produce a bunch of artifacts. And if we follow the digital thread through this process view of the simulation, we can get to an artifact which represents the results of my simulation. So let me go ahead and open that, and we can see it as an image view. But perhaps more interesting is this 3D view that's showing us how the heat distribution happens after I turn the heating element on.
Yep.
How that heat propagates through this nozzle assembly. That might have something to do with the clogging. Let's pretend in this case that it doesn't. Jump back to my digital thread view, or my where use view, and I can see, oh, well, look, there's another problem report that's actually already been issued. And this problem report is indicating that we have nozzle clogging. So here now, we're going to trace the digital thread again through from nozzle clogging, the problem that's been reported, trace it through this corrective action plan. We see that now we have root cause analysis that has actually been performed against this. And as we expand that, now we can drive into the cause itself. And from the cause, we can drive into the risk analysis that predicted that this might actually happen. And from that risk analysis, we can get back to the original extruder part and expand further into the requirements documents to be able to see and follow this link to see whether or not the extruder was actually living up to its original requirements.
Okay.
So you see that thread is the most important thing is being able to trace
go back from the problem back to the original design.
Or vice versa.
Yeah.
If you have a requirement, you're able to go forward forward traceability to determine whether it's performing up to its specifications.
Is it true that there's a bunch of different applications that are being integrated into this Innovator platform? And like what would an engineer have to do if they didn't have this? Like, you know, pencil and paper or other platforms, email, I'm assuming they would have.
Lots of that kind of thing going on. They'd probably be logging into 6 or 7 different systems to get all all this information. And they wouldn't have really any way to correlate the data between the systems because they use different numbering conventions and different naming. They might not even have a license to get into the quality management software, for example, or the manufacturing execution software. So by going through this digital thread platform, we're able to bring everything together into a single user interface, a single viewpoint for everyone to collaborate together.
And would other people within the company also have access to this? And that's where, you know, maybe a customer service rep could then...
Absolutely.
If the same problem keeps happening over and over again, they can already see that things have been addressed or they're being worked on, kind of a thing.
That's absolutely our goal. Yeah. And the way we handle licensing, not to get into too much detail, but we encourage companies to have thousands and thousands of users. We have dozens of companies that have 10,000 or more users that are accessing this. So it's really important to spread the wealth,
I started with this is cloud-based. So this is all a cloud-based system that's subscription. You don't have to install anything on your own computers or servers.
Nothing
or
like that. Just subscribe to the SaaS offering and you get access to all this. And we include through that offering the connectors to all the relevant engineering and manufacturing quality systems.
And I know we only focus on a few of the features. There's a lot of other cool features about this too, right? So where can people go for more details?
So Aras.com is probably your best bet.
Okay.
You get a lot of detail there. We can, from there, you can download case studies and watch videos, demos, more detailed demos than we had today. Lots of information on Aras.com.
All right, Rob McAveney, thanks again for showing us this and thanks for the demo.
Thank you very much.